Ogden is about to get its own eye in the sky to fight crime. It's not a helicopter or a plane. It's a blimp. ABC4's Noah Bond is live in the studio, and this, I guess, would be the first crime-fighting blimp in Utah?
It is, and probably the first in the entire nation. It's designed and manufactured right here in Utah, and it's loaded with old military technology.
The unmanned blimp is 52 feet long, 4 feet in diameter, weighs under 20 pounds, and can fly 40 miles per hour. Two thrusters can turn it in 360-degree turns.
I think it's a little strange to all of us. I feel like I have a propeller on my head every time I talk about it. It's a little Jetson-like.
From 400 feet in the air, one high-definition camera sends live video of license plate numbers or faces to police. The other infrared camera can find moving cars or people in total darkness.
You can literally touch a screen and say, we'd like to follow that vehicle or this person, and the camera will remain focused on that target.
Bradley Stringer is the director of the Utah Center for Aeronautical Innovation and Design, or UCAID, at Weber State University. He designed the blimp along with other aerial surveillance equipment.
You're looking down on me from the surveiller. It's a four-propped unmanned aerial vehicle also designed by UCAID.
Ogden is not interested in this small device. It can only stay up for short periods of time, but the blimp can guide itself over the city for up to 7 hours, feeding back video.
We have a lot of metal theft, scrap theft out in the industrial park.
Police would place the blimp over high crime areas at night to catch criminals. Now don't think about shooting the blimp down. It's filled with non-flammable helium in multiple chambers.
It still will stay aloft for a long time, even if they shoot a hole in it.
Obviously, some people are skeptical. Ogden is willing to take a risk to keep its citizens safe.
Have an open mind. This is a very low-cost solution to putting a patrolman in the sky.
And Ogden's mayor is still negotiating a price for the blimp. It'll cost somewhere in the high five figures. Now, if a deal is reached, the blimp will be flying over Ogden sometime this spring. Reporting live from the studio, Noah Bond, ABC 4 News.